following is a production of the Department of Broadcasting and Journalism at Western Illinois University.
Live from Salee Hall in high definition, News 3 starts now.
All right. Do you remember the 21st of September?
Well, today is the 21st of September because it's the 21st of September. Good morning, Macomb. I'm Lyandia Cooper.
And I'm Devin Brooks. Today is known to many as Earth, Wind, and Fire Day, and we're celebrating it here on the show. We're still dancing and having fun.
Yes, we are.
Well, today on Good Morning Macomb, I never thought I would dance on the air, but today on Good Morning Macomb, we're going to debut a new segment. It's called Choose Your News. You, the viewer, get to weigh in on a story that you want to see this morning.
We've been getting a lot of votes for the last 12 hours, but it's not too late. You have a few minutes left to vote on the News3's page, so don't miss out.
That's right. Go vote. Also on the show, the executive director of the Macomb Area Economic Development Corporation joins us. Kim Pierce is here to show and to tell us, discuss hundreds of jobs coming to our area. Do you have questions for Kim? Find us on Facebook, and they may be answered on the air. Stay with us for that later in the show. Well, when the season changes, so does the nighttime sky. Did you know that?
I did.
No, I didn't know that. But tonight, you can head over to Argyle Lake State Park and get a view of the varying seasonal constellations.
A WIU astronomy instructor will be leading the stargazing event. During the event, planets, star clusters, and other spatial objects will be observed. The gazing begins at 7 p.m. and is free to attend.
Well, here at WIU, baseball coach Ryan Brownlee took a page out of his dad's book with his team this week. Take a look at this.
Western Illinois University, ROTC, joining and with baseball team to work out bright and early. 6 a.m., the call time to complete the MRF, a military workout, in honor of Michael P. Murphy, a Navy SEAL who died in the line of duty. Coach Brownlee said he has the utmost respect for the military and their service.
All right, well, speaking of, well, we all want some food this morning. We've had some donuts, but that's about it. And a new local eatery is coming to our university, Union.
But many people are wondering why it's not open yet. Mm-hmm. News3's Phil Giovanni reports.
If you're a student at Western Illinois University, then you should recognize this sign. The new Chick-fil-A was announced early mid-June, and renovations of the old Sbarro's have been going on for a couple months. There have been a number of concerns around the opening of the establishment, including where to park. So I sat down with Keitra Russell, the Director of Finance for Auxiliary Facilities here at Western Illinois, to find a solution.
Yeah, so we're currently working with the Director of Auxiliary Facilities, which is also the Director of the Union, to see what we can do about either opening up some different parking spots or especially during our opening weekend. So we're evaluating that right now and working with parking services to see what we can do because we want to have a positive start and not be giving people tickets while they're hopefully coming to support our business.
Students and residents of Macomb seem to be excited. Sophomore Casey Hendrickson briefly and simply explains why.
I think they do need like another option here.
A second concern has been the wait times because of the increased traffic that Chick-fil-A will cause. But will that stop Casey from coming in?
Nope, not at all, no.
You feel that strongly about Chick-fil-A?
Yeah.
Casey continued to say he would wait for the restaurant to open, even if it takes until next spring. But Keitra confidently says we should be expecting it much sooner.
We're getting closer, we're getting there, and we're happy with the timeline so far. So, coming this fall.
For Western Illinois University's News 3, I'm Phil Giovanni.
Right now, the restaurant does not have set hours, but we do know they will be closed on Sundays. Well, coming up after the break, News 3's Molly Naslin has a look at your weekend forecast.
You're watching Good Morning Macomb.
Why I love to do sports anchoring? Because, I mean, it's talking about sports. I decided to come to Western because I wanted an experience that wasn't like some other schools. I did color commentary for one volleyball game. I was terrified. I never did any broadcasting in high school. But when I was talking, it was all, you know, staggered, and I had no idea what I was saying. And now I've done so many different games as a color commentator, play-by-play, now sports anchor. Every show and every game, it gets easier and easier, and I get more comfortable doing it.
I'm Ferdinand. You look at me and think big. You think scary. But I'm a little misunderstood. Sorry, I almost killed you. Involving misunderstood. You're not a fighter.
I don't understand that at all.
Kids with learning and attention issues like dyslexia and ADHD are misunderstood too. Take the time to understand.
Best plan ever.
The right support, everyone can reach their full potential because you can't judge a bull by his cover. Learn more at understood.org.
No doubt you're going places, young lady.
Thank you. And thank you for the interview as well. I can imagine it was the last thing that you wanted to do after such a long campaign meeting.
You really are a very intelligent young woman. You're very smooth.
You're very smooth yourself.
You have no idea.
I want to be able to stand in front of a camera and tell people the story of what the weather's going to be like that day, or be able to tell people, hey, there's something coming your way, you need to take cover, you need to watch out. And being able to stand in front of a camera and tell not only people who are directly involved, but their family members as well, like, this is what's going on, it's been very important to me, because, you know, being in those situations where you are relying on the news to tell you what's going on, I like to be a part of that and helping people with that.
Welcome back.
Take a look at this video sent to us by Dr. Buzz Hume, Associate Dean of the College of Fine Arts and Communication.
He says he has many monarch butterflies invading his backyard right now.
We looked up what a group of butterflies is called, and we have several options.
The internet tells us that we could call a group of butterflies a swarm, maybe a flutter, or even a kaleidoscope, or a flight.
We have to admit, the last one, butterfly, we made up, although we kind of like it.
That's right. These butterflies are on their way to migrating to Mexico, and they've got some warm weather to deal with as they travel south.
Yeah, we're dealing with, like, some cool weather, though, right now.
We are
right?
Dealing with, yes, a little bit cooler weather right now, which is really nice, actually.
Yeah, I'm not complaining.
We're having plenty of cooler weather coming in through here. I'm supposed to be leaving here pretty soon, but, you know.
Right.
Yeah, it's actually really nice outside. It's actually a lot cooler. Normally, we're seeing, like, 90-degree temperatures right now. We finally dropped down to our, you know, regular average temperatures, which is perfect for this time of year, since the start of fall is tomorrow. The first day of fall is officially tomorrow.
That's so cool.
Which means we are getting down to around what our average temperatures are like for this time of year for fall. I can't wait for fall. It's my favorite time of year, really.
Well, we all, yes, can't wait. And right now there's so much cooler weather that people are having to change their clothes,
yes,
and things like,
yes,
that.
Yeah, we are having to change our clothes here, unfortunately. But that's okay, though, because change is good. We like change. Everyone likes change. We like how things change. And we're gonna be seeing how the leaves change here pretty soon, but not yet. We do have some spring flowers here set up for us. Our current temperatures are about 71 degrees. Our winds have picked up since yesterday to being out of the west at 15. That's why it feels just a little bit cooler than what it actually is outside, but that's okay, you know, it's not bad. Again, we are right around average for this time of year, although we have had highs near 94. We did have a little bit of that experience yesterday, but not so much anymore. Again, we did have that pressure system pass through yesterday. That's why we did get these sudden temperature changes, going from 90 degrees yesterday to a 20 degree less difference to the 70s. Now this morning, we do have a lot of clouds over our area, unfortunately, which has been making it feel just a little bit cooler than what it actually is outside. But as to what these clouds contain, not that much. There's not a whole lot going on inside those clouds. They're just blocking the sunlight from us, but that shouldn't last the entire day.
Temperatures across the region today will hit the 70s. In Burlington, unfortunately, you're not going to break the 70s today. You'll be topping out at the upper 60s. Beardstown, though, you will be getting up to 75 degrees today. Temperatures tonight will be very chilly, so make sure you take a jacket if you're going out this evening, because our temperatures are going to get down into the mid-40s, although there are some warm spots around in the lower 50s. However, not for us here in Macomb. Tomorrow, we'll be seeing, again, around what we had today with 70 degrees across the board with 72 in here in Macomb. And then Saturday night, first day of fall, closing out that evening, 40s again, but colder than what we experienced tonight. So again, if you're going out, make sure that you take a jacket. Tonight, again, a low of 46 degrees, partly cloudy skies, with winds coming out of the north at 9 miles per hour, making it feel very chilly out. Tomorrow, we'll have a high of 72 degrees and plenty of sunshine to last us for our first day of fall. Winds are going to drop down a little bit, but still coming out of the north. And then for your 5-day forecast, we have 72 degrees tomorrow for that first day of fall, sunshine on Sunday, but then Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, we're going to start bringing those clouds back in, and we're seeing some rain chances on Tuesday. So,
what I mean for Friday and then for the weekend, it's just pleasant.
It is setting up to be a perfect weekend this weekend.
Yes, I am not complaining.
I know, we're all grateful for it, right?
Yes.
All right. Well, coming up next, voting is wrapping up. Go on Facebook, we'll find out the winner of our first Choose the News poll next on Good Morning Macomb.
I chose Western Illinois University because I could get involved right away. You're going to gain experience. I'm going to be able to just become successful right out the gate. I'll be a news reporter and eventually become a news anchor one day. I've always felt that as a strong speaker, I could be a voice for the voiceless, but as long as I continue to believe in myself, work hard, and show that I want to put my best foot forward, I think that anything is possible.
This is the story of a boy who is very sensitive to lights and sounds. So he built secret hiding places where nothing could get in. The boy didn't like looking people in the eye. It made him feel uncomfortable. One day, he found out he had something called autism. His family got him help. And slowly, he learned how to live with it better.
Early intervention can make a lifetime of difference. Learn the signs at autismspeaks.org.
See on page 4 that the projections need to be tornado. Next Thursday?
Seriously? Thursday? Can't do that.
This is really inconvenient.
I have yoga that day.
I have no time for this.
So.
I can't do Thursday, but I can do Friday.
Disasters? Don't plan ahead. You can. Talk to your loved ones about how you're going to be ready in an emergency. Don't wait. Communicate.
Create your success at Western Illinois University. Automatic scholarships and affordable education and more are all yours at Western Illinois University. Apply today at wiu.edu.
People think I'm trash, but they're wrong. Today I'm just an aluminum can, but one day I could be a stadium.
Now from Macomb in high definition, Good Morning Macomb continues.
Welcome back. I'm Ryan Dia Cooper.
And I'm Devin Brooks. Every show on Good Morning Macomb, we will allow you, the viewer, to vote on stories you want to see on the show.
Polls each week will be posted on our Facebook page with a variety of stories to choose from that will air here on Good Morning Macomb.
Now, we have the results you voted for in this week's Choose the News poll.
We asked you to vote for one of these stories. Judge orders teen to push mole lawn. Mother arrested for taking away daughter's phone.
At 53%, you picked the judge orders teen to mow lawn to air this morning. You can find the other stories on our website, news3wiu.com. So here's the story. An Ohio teen is charged with a crime after mowing a swear word into the grass at a local high school.
But a judge has offered the teen a creative punishment instead of sending him to jail.
It's not your usual punishment.
I was
childish. And now I gotta face the consequences.
And for 19-year-old Cody Scott, mowing this lawn is keeping him out of the slammer. Tuesday, Judge Michael Ciccinetti gave him a choice.
Just a good old-fashioned without a mower.
I'm mowing that.
That's your option?
Yeah.
Okay. Do that instead of 10 days in jail.
In June, Cody and some others cut obscenities into the field with a lawnmower at Fairport Harding High School.
The Fairport police were looking for me and my friends, so I decided to go up there and tell them that it was me, that I did it.
So he's mowing and grateful. Over the years, Judge Ciccinetti has become known for his creative sentences.
You want to screw around with crap? I'll let you do it. That's what you're going to do for 3 days. You can go with the horses, sheep, goats, cows, and pigs at the fair, and you can shovel up their crap after the 4-H leave in the pens.
It's the Ciccinetti way.
Better than jail? I wish I could have got a sentence, like a creative sentence.
But there are some who say Cody got off easy.
I think he should be doing it in the afternoon when it's a lot hotter. You know, maybe learn a little better than now. It's cool right now in the morning.
But after 2.5 hours of manually mowing this lawn, Cody tells me he's learned his lesson.
What do you have to say to Judge Ciccinetti?
I just want to thank him for not sending me to jail. I mean, this was a lot better than going to jail, a lot easier.
Wow, isn't that something? Well, I mean, I guess he kind of got a break. That's kind of easy.
Yeah, but it was pretty funny. The man in the video said, oh, I think he should do it while it's hot outside.
Right. And just pay the price, right? All right.
And more news that can be related to teens meeting up face-to-face may soon be a thing of the past. That's because more of us are relying on our cell phones to communicate with each other.
But as News 3's Emily Stern reports, an increase in phone use doesn't mean an increase in actual talking. Looks like right now we don't have that. So we'll move on. Something else to consider with this story is that the Governor's Highway Safety Association reported for 2017 there were nearly 6,000 pedestrian fatalities because of distracted walking while using a cell phone.
So there are lots of reasons, good reasons, to get out of your phone. Get your heads out of your phone,
yeah,
people.
Yeah, we see a lot of people doing
yes.
that.
Well, coming up next on Good Morning Macomb, several manufacturers in our area are hiring hundreds of people for the next several months.
Yeah, how you can get your hands on the job application and who's hiring. We talk more about this right after the break.
Struggle with hunger. Help end childhood hunger near you. Learn how at feedingamerica.org.
I learned broadcasting for 3 years in high school, so towards my senior year, I was pretty much invested in wanting to pursue a career, and I do enjoy it now, but I'm searching for a way to make sure that it's something that I want to pursue after college. That way I'll be able to wake up every day and say, this is something I want to do, this is something that I love, this is something that I can teach, I can spread, I can affect people with.
Never forget the day our landlord called and said, read your lease, no pets allowed. My owner tells him my dog ate the lease, but that didn't work, and now I'm stuck in a shelter. But this pit bull is ready for a new crib. I'm loving, loyal, and play well with others, so don't be intimidated by all my muscles, because the biggest one I have is my heart. That's right, I said it.
Welcome back. There are five local manufacturers in our area hiring hundreds of positions over the next several months. So here to talk about these openings is Kim Pierce with the Macomb Area Economic Development Corporation. Thanks for joining us and being here this morning, Kim.
You're welcome.
All right. So this is a big opportunity for our community and hundreds of jobs that are open. Kind of tell us, where did this all come from?
So what's happening in our community, and when I say community, I mean the county, our manufacturers have been diversifying their product line and adding in new products that they're putting into production. So between Pella Corporation, NT and Bauer, and Vaughn and Bushnell, in Bushnell, they're creating over 350 new jobs for our area.
Wow. What kinds of jobs are we talking?
We're looking at production, assembly, probably some industrial tech jobs. It's probably a good thing to note that these jobs aren't going to all be created in one day or one week. They're bringing in new equipment every day. They're doing job training. So these jobs will be starting or have already started, and they'll be slowly ramping up over the next 18 to 24 months.
What are some of the qualifications that people would need to?
They're all going to vary. I think if you actually have any industrial background, it would definitely be a plus. Depends on which company you're looking to apply for, but they're going to have their specific needs to that point. Math is always good, maybe a little computer background. Basically, you got to be front and center and just be in tune to the job you're doing, and I think that most anybody could probably get a good job.
Yeah, and this is going to have a huge impact on our local economy.
Oh, absolutely. You know, we're looking to see new people from outside the county move to this area or at least commute here. Our labor force comes from all over, not just in McDonough County. So, you know, it's kind of a housing market boom, maybe, or apartments that might be leased or homes. It's always good to have people in the community that live maybe outside that are spending their dollars at gas stations and our retail and, you know, contributing to our sales tax revenue.
And I believe it was last month that you had the job fair, the drive-through rodeo.
We did. We did our application rodeo. We had just under 300 people drive through, and we are hoping to do pop-up, same thing, but pop-up on campus, actually. As well as in the communities of Bushnell and Macomb. And we'll do that sometime latter part of October into November.
Well, I just think that's a great idea, because the way that it works is you just drive up, you grab that application, and in some instances you can be interviewed on the spot.
Absolutely. Yeah. That's exactly what happened with our one that we did last month. And yeah, we made it very easy. We also made it very kitschy so people would be interested and come out to see it, because, you know, who knows what a job rodeo is. So.
Right, and we have a question also from one of our viewers on our Facebook page. Lynn says, are the jobs seeming to be filled by locals, or are they attracting new people to our area?
I think it's probably a little of both. If anyone is actually actively looking for a job, they should be able to find one. And don't get discouraged if you go out and make an application and you don't get called immediately, because as I said, all these companies are ramping up their production. So it's going to take some time for that training and to get all those individuals hired, but it's there. So, you know, follow up with it. If you don't get called, just keep after it.
So let's go through one more time. Which manufacturings are hiring, and exactly kind of what do they do?
It's the Pella Corporation, which makes windows. NT and Bauer, Vaughn and Bushnell, and then we also have Yetter Manufacturing.
And then a lot of them have two locations. They have different trucking and manufacturing that's in Colchester and then also in Macomb as a warehouse.
Right. We have Wayland, which used to be a subsidiary of Yetter, which is located in Colchester, but they're both considered Yetter Manufacturing now with facilities in both communities. Schold and Bushnell is in Bushnell, and then Vaughn and Bushnell Hammer Factory is in Bushnell as well.
Okay. And how can people pick up an application if they're interested?
They can go online for several of them. They just need to look, and they can also go directly to the company and ask to make an application, and sometimes get an interview the same day.
All right. Well, I thank you for joining us this morning, Kim Pierce with Macomb Area Economic Development Corporation. And again, hiring will take place over the next several months. You can pick up an application at the Macomb Area Economic Development Corporation's office, their new location, which is located at 1406 East Carroll Street. All right, thanks again for joining.
Thank you.
All right, stay tuned because after the break, Molly Naslin will have your final weather. You're watching Good Morning Macomb.
I understand. I know it's not your typical resume.
Okay, well.
But. Candidate. But I've been working double shifts just to pay for books. I've been raising my two little brothers. I'm determined, driven, motivated. Isn't that what you're looking for?
Look beyond the resume and discover new ways to develop great talent at gradsoflife.org.
Eva Marie smoked 12,000 packs of cigarettes over 15 years. She quit, and now there's a new lung cancer screening that could save her life. You stopped smoking, now start screening. No matter how much you've smoked, early detection could save you. Talk to your doctor or learn more at savedbythescan.org.
I started to think about doing broadcasting my freshman year. I started calling some football games for the freshman football team. My high school didn't really have a broadcasting program like some do, and so a lot of my stuff was just PA for different sports, for basketball, for volleyball. And my mom signed me up for a visit to come to Western on a Discover Western day. And I walked through the doors of the rec center, and Buzz Hoon shook my hand and said, "Zach Stone, I've seen all your footage. I know who you are, and you belong here." And that's what really makes WIU feel like home.
National Broadcasting Society helps the future of broadcasting get the tools needed to succeed in an ever-growing media world. At Western Illinois University, the professional connections students bring to our chapter of MBS have opened doors to networking possibilities that students otherwise wouldn't have. The opportunities we are given as students at WIU allow us to make connections today for success tomorrow.
As the days of fall get shorter and shorter, the color of leaves get brighter. You may believe that the natural color of leaves is green, but that's not always the case.
The actual color of leaves are revealed when the chlorophyll vanishes. This fall foliage map shows the progression of color change as we get further into the fall season. Now, Molly, a lot of this we don't understand. Yes. Lydia and I, we don't understand. So can you explain this a little?
So a lot of, like you said, fall leaves show their color when the chlorophyll in the plant starts to disappear, and that is because the weather is getting colder and there isn't as much UV light coming in to actually give the plant its energy that it needs. So the map that you can see here, green, there's not a whole lot of change here. This is actually for September 24th. This is coming up here in a few days. So as you can see, you know, there's not a whole lot of change. As we come in further to, you know, late, early October, little bit more change. There's a little bit more orange and yellow, meaning that some changes are starting to happening, especially to our north. And then later in October, getting closer to November, there's a lot more change. Most of the green is down in the south, where it's still warm like you would expect. And in our area, we're seeing the yellow and the orange, meaning that that's when we're seeing all of those color changes. And then late November going into December, this is when the leaves are starting to fall off the trees, you know, hence the name of the season, fall. So that's where you're seeing the red and the oranges in our area, because most of those leaves have either changed or have fallen off of the trees. Now, speaking of these fall leaves, we have some fall temperatures coming up for us. Again, tomorrow is the first day of fall. We're going to have a high of 72 degrees and a low of 44. So this is typical for what we're seeing around this time of year for fall. Sunday, we're going to warm up just a little bit with plenty of sunshine. Sunday looks like it's going to be the best day this weekend for anything. Saturday, we're going to have a little bit of clouds. Sunday, plenty of sunshine. Monday is when those clouds are going to start to roll in. We'll have a high of 78 and a low of 62. There's not a whole lot of fluctuation in the temperatures that day. Tuesday, however, is when we'll start to see those rain chances. Wednesday, that'll move out of the area with just some clouds.
Some great weather on tap the next few days and a lot of activities going on, so it'll be great for the outdoors.
Perfect weekend.
All right, well, thank you for joining us this morning for our first Good Morning Macomb of the semester. Catch News 3 live at 4 on Tuesdays and Thursdays.
Find us on Facebook or Twitter. Just search News 3 WIU.
From all of us at News 3, have a good morning, Macomb.